Good afternoon, everyone. Just a moment, I will share our presentation and let's start. Yes, my name is Alexandra. I'm coordinator at CSR Ukraine, and today I will moderate our very relevant discussion on the role of CSR during the COVID-19 pandemic. First of all, thank you very much to the organizers and partners for initiating such an important discussion, as well as to our speakers who will present their cases of their own companies during the pandemic. And it's very important now that these CSR webinars can give us a chance to understand how business can help during the pandemic. So let's start. Today is a time when corporate social responsibility is urgent. We know and we can see the most of companies are willing to help society to protect against COVID-19. In such times of crisis, social responsibility becomes an important visit card of company. And the first question the company will be asked after the quarantine, what did you do during the pandemic? And it's better to have an answer to this question. This is the kind of work license that society provides to business. So let's listen to answer to this question by three Ukrainian companies. And I'm happy to introduce our today's speakers from Ukraine. Yanina Olkhovska, Head of Communications, CSR and Engagement of UKRSIB Bank, BNP Paribas Group. Oleksandra Chichko, CSR Specialist at Intellius, and Kristina Gensirovska, Senior Corporate Communications and CSR Specialist of Metro Cash & Carry Ukraine. Now our experts will share the experience of their companies during the pandemic, the initiatives that have been implemented during this time, the challenges companies have had to meet, the decisions and results that have been achieved, and recommendations for other companies. So let's start. And Yanina Olkhovska, you are welcome.
Hello, everyone. Alexandra, I would like to ask you to share my presentation. For me, today it's very pleasant to be here, yes, and to share information and to share our experience, UKRSIB Bank experience regarding this unusual situation. Also, I would like to say we have experience not about regarding of COVID pandemic crisis. Also, if you speak in global CSR questions, of course, we are working on ESG issue or sector policy and green product for our clients, potential and existing clients, etc., etc. But if you have questions not about COVID, yes, I would like you can ask and I will answer. Please, next slide. Before I will explain to our experience, I would like to share with you short information about the UKRSIB Bank. UKRSIB Bank has been operating in the Ukraine market since 1990. We have big stories in Ukraine. Yes, and also UKRSIB Bank is a part of BNP Paribas Group, is one of the largest financial group in the world. And the second, our shareholders is EBRD, you can see on the slide. We have, I can say we are one of the biggest international bank in Ukraine, and you see the information. We have more than 250 branches in the city, 9 cities, and we have more than 2 million customers in Ukraine. And of course, for us, it's very important to serve our clients, to provide to them very quality service, and of course, to make financial life of our clients simple, safe, and rewarding. Next slides, and now I would like to discuss and to share information with you about our 2020. You see on the slide the pictures, yes, photos from presentation. This presentation is this photos from presentation of our CEO Laurent Dupouche in previous in December previous on previous year we had a big conference, online conference, top 500. And of course, we discuss a two-day conference, and of course, we discuss about challenges, opportunities, and about 2020. And you see the on this slide, the main messages. Yes, of course, for us, 2020, it was unpredictable year. Yes, of course, and the year was with a lot of challenges, and of course, with a lot of opportunities. We had the time and we had the situation when, which we needed to update. We changed our business model. We had a lot of battles with this crisis, if you're speaking about clients, as the clients, as in employees, and in the market. Of course, we started to think about how we change our, how we can be more digital, and how we can care more about our employees, about clients. We implemented new service, digital service for our clients, and also we try to care for our employees as much as possible. And our pillars, which we had in 2020, people care, trust, and positive management. It was very important for us. And of course, we understood the virus is still circulating and continue to be vigilant. And now, next slide, please, a little bit about our customers. Of course, previous year, can you imagine 1 year ago? Yes, it's the time, it was very quick, but we decided to make financial life for our clients more digital. And more than 60 functionality of our internet banking we provided for free for our clients. And also we decided to create and to implement new service for our clients. And you see on the slide for individual clients, what we started to do, the first of all, online onboarding, online acquisition, online identification and re-identification. According to NBU, according to regulation, we need to identify our clients minimum three times per year. On 3 years. Also, we decided to provide new service for our clients, car delivery, credit online, credits special condition for grace period, and of course, a new service regarding non-cash transfer from European Union and United Kingdom. For SME, for medium and small business and corporates, big corporate clients. Of course, for us very important was also to provide for them very quality service. And previous year, we implemented new internet platform, the name of this platform, UkrSIB Business. And we also, our task was to provide really useful service because we had a lot of issues, and of course it depends of our issues and depend of our problems we need to operate our business. And we launched this new platform UkrSIB Business, and we provide new service on this platform. Also, for us, it's very important was educate our clients, potential clients and existing clients. And previous year, we conducted 19 professional seminars and events for our customers. You see on the slide more than 4,000 clients participated. And of course, our employees on the branch, our relationship managers of corporate banking on headquarters provided for our clients service online. by phone, by different online meetings, and to support our clients every day. And also what we started to do, we implemented new way of consultation. I can say it's a 24 hours of consultation for our clients. We have on our internet banking chatbot, and all our clients can ask us different questions regarding of their financial situation 24 hours, and our clients received the answers of this answers. Next slide, please. Of course, for this situation, we needed a budget. What we started to do, we started to rearrange our budget. And of course, one of the article we removed for special budget, the name of this budget, the COVID budget, crisis budget, and all budget which we decided to remove from one article to another article. It was very important to use and to manage this budget on smart way. And you can see the diagram of this budget, 55%, we decided to spend for personal protection equipment for our employees and also for our clients. If you go to our branches, you can see all our cashiers have a special window. Yes, and this window can save and can protect our client, our employees. And also we bought a lot of gloves, masks, sanitizers, different equipment for support and for protect of our employees. What we started to do also for us very important was to propose and to give our employees work remotely. And you can see on the slide, 100% of headquarters employees have opportunity work remotely today. This is approximately 60% of bank employees. And of course, on lockdown period in April, we also provided this opportunity for our employees in the branch. What I can say additionally, when we had this lockdown in April, we arranged for our employees transport. And also we arranged for them a special condition for working, special schedule. And of course we care about our, I can say, sensitive employees. This employees, girls who are ready to be a mother, yes, and our employees who has more than 60, the risk zone employees, I can say. And in September, we decided to provide PCP testing of our employees. I would like to say not for all, we provided this opportunities for who works with clients every day. The next slide, please. And the next point, it's very important for us, is communication. After 1 month, we understood we need to share, we need to communicate, we need to speak with our employees. And from April, we decided to arrange special YouTube conference for our employees. We decided to create new ways of internal communication. YouTube conference, what does it mean? Each month we had YouTube conference for our employees, and our employees had opportunity to ask any questions regarding of crisis situation. The second, we open the special Telegram canal for our employees, and we put information about the different situation and useful information for our employees. Second or third part, we provide for our employees special hotline, hotline service. Why we did this? Because not only some of our employees had some, I can say, psychical issue, and we decided to make some psychological hotline. Also, it was very important to send and to create and to send special visualization for all our offices and for all our branches. You can see the one of the example of this visualization and on the slide. And also for us was very important communicate not only like officially, yes, and give officially information to our employees, and also non-official, non-formal, I can say, communication. For example, one of the conferences which we had, it was one of the YouTube stream which we had, it was 18th of June. We had 30th anniversary of Ukrsi Bank, and all top managers celebrate together and to give some celebration to all our employees by YouTube. Next slide, please. Next, it's about the events, about the meetings, and about the video conference. Of course, we need to speak with our employees and we need to speak with our clients. We use different instruments, but maybe you know bank, it's very strict organization, and unfortunately we can't use officially Zoom, we can't use officially different instruments which can use every day, and we are using only really safe instruments. You can see we are using Cisco WebEx. And now also we are using and BNP Paribas also Microsoft team. We have 20 Cisco rooms, we have 20 Cisco WebEx rooms. We have special line for conference call, and we have very interesting and useful instrument tools for communication. And also if you're speaking about events, previously, till 2020, every year we conducted approximately 30 different offline events for our employees. Of course, this year it's online. It's not a lot, but very quality events. We conducted events for top management of Ukrsi Bank, top 500. We conducted special events for personnel who are working with clients every day, for SME clients and for premium clients. It's more than 1,200 employees. And we received a lot of positive feedback. You can see the one of the examples on the slide, and also you can see the information on our official Facebook page. Next slide, please. It's the last slides, and Marina and Alexandra asked us about to provide some advices here and some tips which we can advise you, which we can to promote, I can say. The first of all, world is changing even faster. And of course, we cannot forecast everything. It's very, very difficult in today's situation. And what we need to be agile. The first advice and the first tips which we can provide to you, dear colleagues, dear audience, be prepared. Be prepared and to create different scenarios for different situations. For example, in December, we decided and we created scenarios if we have, for example, lockdown 100%, 75%, 50%. And of course, our task is business continue process, not to stop our operation, because Financing is one very important topic for our clients and for everybody. Can you imagine if bank tomorrow closed? It's not possible. Yes, that's the first we need to think about, and we need to operate you every day. The second topic and this very important point is involving of all levels of management. About the people care, about the client care. What we are doing? We communicate all information. The second, if we have in our team some issue, we communicate. If we have some problem with health of our employees, we communicate. We collect this information, yes, and we provide to support. It's very, very important to involve all employees and to share information about on all the bank, I can say, but of course it's very confidential if you're speaking about the name. The third point, communication is key. To speak, to share, and to communicate. And the third and the fourth, think positive. Now we are creating the strategy 22-25. In one of the main pillars, positive banking. I would like to say, yes, it's a strategic pillar, but from 2020, our positive impact, our focus on sustainable growth, it's our DNA. And I would like to say, I wish you really strong health, be care, and be prepared. Thank you.
Janina, thank you very much. Also, if someone have any questions, you can type in chat, and after all presentations, we can ask these questions. So let's continue. And Alexandra Chuchko, you're welcome to share your presentation.
Hi again. I'm very glad to be here. So thanks a lot for having me. Just give me one sec. To share the presentation. I think it's working now.
Yeah.
Yeah, great. So hi, everyone. My name is Alexandra, and I'm very thrilled to be here today. And I'm really happy to share my experience, our experience with you, and I really hope that it will be useful, and that others can take some insights and outputs and use in your work. So let me give you a quick overview about what Intellias is. It's one of the biggest IT companies in Ukraine. We operate in mostly in Western Europe, but also we have some clients from the United States, and recently we've got some clients in Israel and Saudi Arabia, so we are growing pretty fast, and for now we have 1,500 employees in five offices around Ukraine. When the pandemic started, our employees were the key focus of our action steps, and we've taken several activities in different areas to support our employees to make sure that they are safe and they're okay and they can work and they have everything that they need. And the second thing that we focused on, it was the society, because we understand that business cannot operate just separately, and the pandemic is influencing everyone, all the other spheres, so we tried to check where our efforts will be the most useful, and we've chosen to contribute to mass testing, and I will just give you a little deeper dive into all of the steps and what we've resulted with. So first of all, we started with switching to remote work, and we've put a lot of efforts to this, and we did it pretty fast. In March, 96% of our employees were switched to work from home, and we've created the special cross-functional team that was responsible for ensuring that everyone has what they need. So the administrative office was gathering the requests from our employees and engineers about what they need. For example, it was not only hardware or some devices or accessories, it was also chairs and tables, because we know not everyone has the working place at home, and it's really important to have this atmosphere where you can work and all the needed equipment. Also, we have like everyone, we have our processes being online and remote right now, and onboarding was one of that. So all of our newcomers are receiving their welcome packs and some instructions and devices as well through delivery services or taxi. Also, all the meetings with HR people, with their managers, with some tech support as well, they have online, and everything is done in the way so people can stay safe and can stay home and not to risk with their health. Also, what is very important that my colleague mentioned before, it's a communication, and it's really a crucial. It was really crucial for us to establish clear and constant and regular communication. So we've taken pretty much a lot of actions to this to make it happen. We have our work from home chat. We have our online kitchen, where we gather every Friday in the morning with a cup of coffee, and some of our colleagues are sharing at some topic that is interesting for everyone. It was like about coffee, about bicycles, about mental health. We also invite different speakers from experts from outer world, you know, to share on other topics. For example, on the 4th of January, of February, it was International Cancer Day. So we invited the CEO of the NGO that is working with cancer people, with people who are sick with cancer. So yeah, she shared about how to treat people, how to support, how to avoid, and so on. So we try to have regular touch points, and both professional and personal with our colleagues, and it's working really nice for us. We've run some tests and surveys, and also we have constant communication with our clients, and the performance is not lower than it was before. So we are really proud of that, and we think that the communication, both professional, all of these chats and meetings and gatherings that we have, for example, we have monthly updates from CEO, we have different town halls to keep everyone updated on what's going on in the company and on the project. So events, like I mentioned, on different topics, all of this contributes to the situation that we have now, that we are actively recruiting and we are growing, so our clients are satisfied with our work and people are okay with what we have. Also, we understand that pandemic has changed our world, not temporarily. It will be, some changes will be constant and will not go away after the pandemic will end. So we developed the IntelliSmart Workplaces concept. What does it mean? After the pandemic will, I don't know, be less than right now, and there will be people who will would like to go back to the office, so everyone can choose a comfortable way of working. For example, I don't have place at my home, and I really would like to work from office, so I have a fixed desk, and then if I would like to share with to change sometime to work from home, sometimes to work from office. I can have this 50-50 concept, and then people who would like to stay at home, they still can stay and work from home. The next one was safety kits. At the beginning, I don't know if in Turkey it was like this, but in Ukraine, it was really, really stressful to find some personal safety things, for example, sanitizers or masks or gloves. So a lot of our employees also stated that they have some troubles finding this. So a company ordered and packed the safety kits that we delivered also through delivery services. And yeah, they basically included all the basic stuff, but it was really important for us not to only send everyone away, but also ensure that they can go safely to the store and buy some foods for them. Yeah, it was around 1,000 of this kind of kits delivered, and we received a lot of appreciations from our colleagues. And the last one, it was happening at the beginning of the autumn. We realized that we have some cases in our company of people who've been sick. And that's why we decided to devote some resources, and we provided extra insurance additionally to what we have already that is covering COVID-19 disease. Yeah, the other part that we were focusing on, it was helping our country to deal with consequences. And we were thinking and having some advices from the experts where our efforts will be the most useful. And we've seen that the mass testing, it was the one area where to invest to. So yeah, we used to buy some rapid tests, and we delivered them with our partners to the most vulnerable groups. It was medics and older people, because we believe that restraining the spread of the virus is also important, and it prevents from further losses of money and other resources, and I don't know, places even in hospitals. So yeah, we had several partners with that, and I think we were at the beginning of the pandemic, we were the first company to start this initiative, and we are super glad that a lot of other companies joined and supported this initiative, and especially in Lviv region, it was pretty big area, and a lot of people used those tests, and I think we've contributed a bit to make coronavirus spreading not so much as it could. And yeah, about recommendations, you know, our tagline is engineering by people, and we put this humanely approach to everything what we do. So yeah, all the recommendations are also about this. The first one is to take care of your employees. It doesn't matter what kind of company you are, it's just being humane, it's just being a human. And then establishing regular communication, that what worked for us. And lately we were sharing with our partners and customers some guidelines how to do this, and it was useful for them. Also ensuring protection, I mean this insurance, additional insurance that can be provided for all the employees. It just, you know, maybe it will not be so helpful in case of the disease, but just the knowing that my company cares for me, and in case of something, I have this insurance, it makes me feel personally very, very great. And yes, taking care of mental health and well-being. There are a lot of ways to achieve that, but just taking it into consideration while planning all the activities, it's a nice thing to do. Yeah, basically that's it. If you have some questions, I'll be glad to answer.
Alexandra, thank you very much. It's very useful experience for other companies and for all who will listen to this webinar. Thank you. And Kristina Gensirovska, just a moment, I will show your presentation.
Thank you, Alexandra. Good afternoon.
So let's start.
Good afternoon, dear colleagues. My name is Kristina Hansirovska, and I am responsible for CSR and sustainability projects in Metro Cash and Carry Ukraine. Today, I would like to share with you our initiatives that our company made to fight against COVID-19. But first of all, let me introduce you our company so you will have the full picture of changes or stability of our CSR and sustainability projects in time of new reality. The next slide, please. So our company Metro is one of the biggest retailer in Europe. Our headquarters is in Düsseldorf, Germany. And in 2003, Metro started operated in Ukraine. We have over 16 million of customers all over the world and operates in 34 countries all over the world. In Ukraine, we have 26 stores, 23 of which is classical Metro Cash and Carry, and three, it's the stores of small format. I would like to mention that our country is in the 46th place and Germany is in 63rd place out of 195 countries in terms of its territory. However, imagine that according to the FAO, our countries, the territory of these huge countries are not enough not enough to grow food that will never be in our place. So Alexandra, please the next slide. Yeah, that's right. A third of foods that were grown never was eaten, but this all food thrown in the landfill. And this is when every ninth inhabitants of planet suffers from hunger. That's why our company has our own initiatives cooperating with Food Bank. Food Bank, this is one of the biggest foundation in Ukraine, which cooperate with our company and we fight against hunger. We help people in need in 18 cities all over Ukraine. It almost 18 organizations in all the cities of our Ukraine. So the next place, Alexandra. Next slide, please. So the new reality starts in March 2012. We all get acquainted with this term that divided our lives into before and after. Like most of Ukrainians, our company, our customers, and all Ukrainians suffer from this COVID-19. And Metro Ukraine has also affected this situation. We put our company one very important goal: to make sure that nothing can stop us from doing our work responsibly and securing our customers, also our employees. Metro Heroes. We started to call our colleagues Metro Heroes. Despite all that potential risks, they work with thousands of customers every day by supporting them. They also are an important part of our sustainability projects. Also, our colleagues are crucial part to help us implement all Ukrainian projects, which meet the most urgent needs of local communities. When the pandemic begins, all responsible business join forces to defeat an invisible enemy. Our company also joins the significant movement and following the recommendations of the National Health Service, Metro chose the way to help the society with food donations, while the company has wide experience in supporting people in need by providing them with humanitarian aid. Next, please, Alexandra. Yes, we understood that high quality and safe products are now very essential for doctors, for patients, and elderly people. So in March 2012, Metro Ukraine provided as a humanitarian aid in form of food and non-food donations to hospitals treating people with COVID to six big cities in Kyiv, Odessa, Lviv, and Dnipro and Kharkiv. In the East European Foundation became a partner of implementation of this project. Also, we cooperate with Food Bank as our reliable partner. So together we provided about 16 tons of buckwheat, sugar, wheat, other social goods, more than 13,000 units of meat, vegetables and fish, canned goods, detergents and personal goods for staff and patients of hospitals. In April 2012, our company made the second step to fight against COVID, and we provided people, elderly people in need, with 5,000 kits that included different necessary goods of first need. It was oil, sugar, pasta, buckwheat, corn, canned vegetables, and so. The partner in the implementation of this project also become Kyiv City Food Bank charitable organization. The next slide, please, Alexandra. And in the end of April, our company has responded to the Ministry of Health call to join the nationwide campaign supporting doctors by joining its forces with our HoReCa customers. In Lviv, we cooperate with FAST. In Kyiv, Dnipro, and Kharkiv, we cooperated with Mafia. In Odessa, we cooperate with Restaurant U and Citronelle restaurant in Kyiv, which became our partner as of May. Together with our partners, we provided hot meals for doctors combat coronavirus. And our company provided for free of charge and very good quality product. And our HoReCa partners, they prepared each day 240 meals to doctors and delivered it to the hospitals. Also, more than ever, we need to set an example for responsible behavior towards the planet and for caring coexistence. I should also mention that the effective driver of positive changes in field of minimizing the impact on environment in Ukraine, in our society. This is also the main reason why we have our responsible consumption strategy. And in the next slide, you may see our Metro waste collection points. We collaborated in May. We collaborated with Kyiv Council State Administration and implemented a project on the responsible and ecological utilization of used masks and gloves. In our four Metro stores in Kyiv, you may find boxes where you can leave these your gloves and masks, and our company utilize it in a proper way. Therefore, also in July 2012, our company opened waste collection points in Poltava, in Mykolaiv, Lviv, Mariupol, and Kharkiv. And in September, the classic recycling center in Odessa. The next slide, please. So as you can see, Metro decided to continue our waste collection point strategy, and we do all our best in order to give chance the responsible citizens of these cities. Also, we have 11 waste collection points all over Ukraine. To be responsible, and everyone can bring to our points glass, waste paper, plastic, Tetra Pak, aluminum cans, and slag. So this project will be continued, and also we have another very interesting project that we implemented in new reality. Next slide, please. Our annual charitable campaigns. In August, Metro Ukraine, together with our partners, Zakaz UA online platform and Self-Serve IT company, joined forces to help children in need within the framework of our Back to School charitable initiative. This initiative is our All Ukrainian initiative, and we cooperate for the first time with IT company and do it online. Self-Serve and Foodway became our partners, and our clients have the opportunity not only to donate goods in our stores, but also they can donate online. All they need is to click and decide which aid they want to donate. And after that, pay for these donations. Our company and Zakaz UA delivered all these donations that were made online to charitable organizations and to children and people in need. Also, I would like to mention the next slide, please. Yes, we all know that it's very important to be partners in easy times. But the even most important is to continue this strong collaboration in difficult times. So we understand that this year brought to all of us different challenges, but also our approach to protect, preserve, and to attack helps Metro Cash & Carry Ukraine team to guarantee safety to our employees and customers, to ensure stable business operations and search for new opportunities. And in 2021, we will do all our best to stay a trustworthy partner to the society and also become the champion for independent business. So these very important quotes: assume responsibility, think ahead with a view to the future, deal sustainably, set yourself high standards economically, environmentally, and socially. This is all the guiding principles to Metro Sustainables. And thanks to this, we cope with all challenges and make our contribution to our society. Thank you for your attention. Thank you. Take care.
Christina, thank you very much. It's very interesting. And if someone have questions, please type in chat and we ask these questions. And there were very interesting Ukrainian cases and so valuable recommendations. And I can mention precise three tips that these companies provided during the pandemic. First, it's taken care, and also it's new digital solutions. It's very good and very useful. Also new ways of communications with employees, with clients, with administration and others, and real activities to fight COVID-19 during this period. And I also have a few additional questions. It's short questions, so I want to ask you also. Let's continue a topic about pandemic. And now we have a new challenge or new opportunity, and it is vaccination. What are your plans, I mean your company's plans, for COVID vaccination of your employees? What your companies should do in this regard?
I can start then. We recently had this conversation during our status meeting, and from what I know, our colleagues are actively searching for opportunities to order these vaccines, but we have some struggles with the Ministry of Health in Ukraine, and it takes some efforts from their side as well to make it available for companies and for some private sectors players to order and somehow contribute maybe to also vaccination of the whole population. And as far as I know, they are not very active in terms of this. So from my side, I would say the companies are ready and they are willing to protect their employees, but there are still some obstacles, and we will see what we can do about it.
Thank you, Alexandra. Christina, Janina, can you
Thank you. I can add that first of all, every basis, every year we provided for our, and we proposed for all our employees vaccine against flu. And I can say previous year, October, November, we also did this, and previous year it was more popular than before. And about COVID against vaccine against COVID, of course, we are under discussing these questions, and we have a plan, but our plan depends on Ukrainian reality. But we have a plan, and we investigate this issue very careful and very, no, for us it's very important, because caring about the people is, and about employees, it's one was our first priority. Thank you.
Yes, Alexandra, I would like also to add from our side. First of all, let me note that the health and safety of Metro Cash and Carry Ukraine employees are one of the most important tasks of our company. That's why all staff, besides a special COVID package with medical insurance, also have life insurance as of March 2012. And our company cannot give the final answer to this question, because there are different factors that will influence our final decision. First of all, the availability of this vaccine. The second, the quality of vaccine that will purchase Ukraine. And the third, as we know from the practice of different countries, first of all, the vaccine get some frontliners. Front workers, for example, doctors, firemen, teachers. And when we talk about the society, we need to wait at least 1 year. But it doesn't mean that our company not following all the news according to this issue. We monitor all of them. And as soon as we know that in Ukraine there is available high quality and safety vaccine, we will start the negotiation with our medical insurance representatives. So time will show, but now I confidently can say that our company always try to do our best to feel all employees safe in our Metro ecosystem.
Okay, thank you. Very interesting. And one more question. You partly mentioned it, but how has the pandemic affected other CSR projects that the company has previously implemented? Were all of them transformed under these new conditions, or some may have closed, or something else?
Maybe I will start. I can say that we really miss the live communication, because one of the most important part of our CSR project is the involvement of our employees as volunteers, as mentors, to help children in need, for example, to communicate with them. We participated in different initiatives. For example, we have different workshops for children, cooking, culinary, some workshops, handmade. So we really appreciate to have this opportunity to communicate, have a live communication. And this year, when we, for example, have our Metro Mykolai regular initiative, last year, over 13 employees were with me, and we have a good opportunity to visit this orphanages. And now only two of our representatives can go and just give presents. So it's very important for us to have this live communication. But yes, we have some transformation. As I mentioned, we have the opportunity to widen our communication, our projects online, through online channels, find new different collaborations. So also it's a good opportunity, but yeah, live communication is very important, especially when we talk about CSR and sustainability.
I understand. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I would like to add also, we a little bit relocate our budget from charity activities to this COVID crisis activities, yes, again, but not a lot, yes, because we decided to continue all our project, charity project. If you're speaking about the CSR, sustainable project, no, we not cancel. I think we maybe wide, yes, and we also agreed with colleagues from Metro, we, the communication is key and we need to more communicate about this. I think this situation, which started previous year, gave like a push and attract more attention on some sensitive topic. If you're speaking about the charity, if you're speaking about the health, if you're speaking about different social program. And I think it's very important because previous year we did August and September, we did the special marketing research, and we asked, it was quality research, and we asked our existing and potential clients what does it mean for them CSR. And if previously it was only bank need to support me if I have some problems, or bank needs to save my money, but previous year we received additional answers about the health, support of health, to help different NGO, etc. And for, I think it's really good opportunities and possibilities to increase CSR activities.
Thank you very much. Alexandra, can you add something?
Honestly, for us, it was a bit hard. And because at the beginning of pandemic, you know, our partners were like, whoa, slow down, maybe, I don't know, cut some engineers, maybe we don't need that much of software right now. Yeah, because we mainly work with the automotive sector, and in Germany, it was pretty tough as well. So yeah, some of factories closed and some delays were happening. So at the beginning, our focus was on keeping the business at the same level, at least. And that's why all the budgets were relocated to that place. But now, after everything like is more settled right now, we begin again, like we start from the beginning, and we put more efforts to our corporate social responsibility projects. And we, right now, we are looking for some really nice and big projects in areas of eco-mobility, because as we saw, this topic becomes even more relevant, you know, this personal transportation, like bikes and scooters, and all of this opportunities for people are most more important right now in terms of keeping everyone safe and making these connections less and giving more opportunities to be, I don't know, alone on the street. So yes, at the beginning it was like less, and we were cutting the budgets, but now we are starting to be back on track.
Cool, thank you so much. One more question: how COVID-19 influenced the strategic planning of your companies? Because talking constantly with businesses in recent months, I hear that companies have begun to plan for shorter periods. I mean, not for 5-10 years ahead, but for example, 2-3 years. How has this changed in your companies? And do we still need to plan for the long term at all?
I can start on my presentation. I a little bit covers this topic. Now we under creation of our strategy 2022-2025. Previous year we decided to do 2021-2024, but we decided and maybe 20 this year it's like a period of analyzing of previous situation and preparation for the next steps. But we have and we have a plan, we have a strategy, we have a main pillars. Of course, one of the main pillars of digitalization, in other customer service, talent acquisition and development of people, agile way, and of course, positive banking and positive impact. We have very strong plan, and we will be ready to communicate our strategy in the beginning of the next year, in 2022. Yes, and we will share this information. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Christina, Alexandra?
I would like also to share our initiatives. We as an international company have our initiative dedicated to United Nations sustainability goals. So we put in our agenda that the first, no poverty, no hunger, and responsible consumption is the main initiatives, the main pillars to our corporate social responsibility and sustainability. It's quite a long process. We have long-lasting projects. We fight against hunger and food waste. It's very important for us. Unfortunately, in Ukraine, we are the one retailer that have this concept of food sharing, and we very appreciate more company to become responsible in such kind of way. Also, we have our waste collection points, and we see how it's important for our society. We get very good feedbacks from people, so we prepared the new formats of this recycling centers. We prepared more collaboration with other partners, so it's very important for us to became stable and sustainable in this kind of projects, where we know that we are the trendsetter, we are the example how to cooperate and operate in this field of sustainability goals. So yeah, we will do all our best to these initiatives and these pillars.
Thank you. Alexandra, can you add something?
Yeah, as I mentioned before, we are now focusing on this eco-mobility topic more. I cannot say for right now that we have made some, very huge changes. I think it was at the beginning in the company's approach to be flexible, to be agile, to respond quickly to whatever happens. So we'll stick to that.
Thank you so much. And the last short question. Let's imagine that you have the opportunity to write one tweet, which will be read by all companies in the world, large, small, medium, all companies in the world. What would you write?
All right, let's make positive impact together.
Perfect, thank you.
I would say be humane, because sometimes humanity is what humanity lacks.
Thank you.
Maybe I will agree with one very famous in Great Britain chef, Douglas McMarket. He told that waste is just the failure of our imagination. So I will answer that, we should be together in order to fight against this waste. It's all in our minds. We should start from us. Each company, small or big, all of us have impact. So collaboration is the key of success.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. And thank you very much for today's very fruitful discussion. Your experience is incredibly important to other companies and organizations that will be listening to this webinar. And thank you that even in such difficult times of uncertainty, you continue to change Ukraine and the world. And by the way, tomorrow on February 17, the world celebrates International Random Acts of Kindness Day. And the good deals should give us pleasure, but we should not expect rewards when giving or helping others. And this is real kindness, and I think this is CSR. And so let's continue to be kind for each other, share insights, recommendations, let's unite, and then we will definitely be able to do everything. Thank you so much. Good luck, and see you soon.
See you. Thank you very much for organization. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thanks for having me. Bye.